Well, hello everyone. How is everyone doing in this mess yourself here? And today, ladies and gentlemen, I am so goddamn excited because I have a very special video. We are checking out Dishonored 2. That's right, baby. I have got early exclusive secret gameplay on Dishonored 2. Basically, the guys over at Bethesda invited me to a secret event in London to capture early Dishonored 2 gameplay just for me and this channel, okay? So shout out to my homies at Bethesda, okay? It's always quite nice when I get invited to these events, okay? Because I feel quite special, okay? So I basically, at this event, played Dishonored 2 for about like 6 hours. And I'm telling you guys, I had so much fun while playing this game. So if you guys don't know what Dishonored is or haven't played the first game, you guys are missing out so goddamn much. I swear it's like one of my favorite games of all time. And Dishonored 2 is like a better version and more expanded version of Dishonored 1. It's got like more levels, more content. I believe there's like a new character you can play as Corvo, which is the main character's daughter, Emily. And Emily has a bunch of new abilities as well. So basically, Dishonored is a stealth game where you play as an assassin, where you have like a bunch of these magical abilities which you're supposed to use to help you take down your target or collect information or collect a piece of items or something like that. And all the levels are designed for you to do these objectives completely stealth, okay? It's basically designed for you to not kill anyone and to not be seen by anyone. And it is possible to do that, but they do give you the option for like guns and like stealth darts and stuff like that. It just in case you're an idiot like me, because the game's hard, okay, but it's kind of hard in a good way. So when you do it stealth and don't kill anyone, it is definitely more rewarding. All right, so let me talk about the gameplay you guys are watching right now. So I'm playing as Corvo, which is the main dude. I've moved a bit ahead of the game. I'm currently on mission 4. And I think I had 2 tasks. And my task was to kill Kirin Jindosh, which was some dude, okay, and rescue a man called Anton Sokolov, okay, and apparently he's being held captured by Kirin Jindosh, and he's basically in this massive mansion, which I have to go in and do these objectives in. Now, Kirin Jindosh is basically this inventor, and I think he's pretty much gone mad. I don't know too much about the level, that's pretty much all I know. He has, like, these security guards in his mansion, and they are scary as hell, okay, and if you go near them, they will literally kill you. I think I died, like, 20 times trying to kill them. It's literally so hard. So like, it is pretty much forcing you to do it completely stealth. What I did notice actually is that if you look on their leg, you can actually rewire them so that they actually become friendly to you and they actually help and go kill enemies for you. And also something else that I noticed is that if you knock out their heads, which is where their sensor is, they actually won't detect you. They only detect you through hearing, okay? So like, it's a really cool level, okay? Really well designed. I really like that sort of design aspect of these stupid killer robots that kept killing me while I was playing this level. So a cool aspect of this level that I really liked is that this Kirin Jindosh dude, he's basically this really smart inventor, and he's designed his house like a trap house, and it's basically like a massive puzzle in order to get from beginning right till the end where he is, okay? You have to like pull levers, and then when you pull the levers around the house, like the whole room around you moves, and you basically have to maneuver your way through this like puzzle house and basically find this guy and kill him and save this other dude, okay? Now, I think there's also a way where you don't actually have to kill him. There's like a workshop room that I found, and I think if you put someone in this sort of like brainwashing machine, I think it fries their brain and like gives them like, I don't know what happened. Basically, I did that when I was playing with the other character, Emily, and basically that was my, I basically completed the level by doing that. So what I'm showing you guys right now is basically some highlights of what I got around playing for about like 4 hours maybe. Now, what I've decided to do, because this gameplay is really good, okay, and I think me talking over it isn't really that great, is I'm gonna upload a second video which should come up, boom, right there. Go watch that, because that is pretty much uncut. Well, I mean, I did cut it down because I want to show you the best bits, but it's basically just full gameplay of Dishonored 2. Basically the highlights, but more, a little bit more in depth. No more Brandon talking. Okay, so you can pretty much watch it, which I really do recommend you guys go check out, because this level was really well designed, and I know why Bethesda wanted to show us this level, because it was really smart how it all played out. And when I did finally kill the target, it was definitely not easy. So when I finally did kill Kirin Jindosh, okay? It felt amazing, okay? And yeah, that's the whole reason why I loved Dishonored 1, and I know I'm gonna just love Dishonored 2, because like the satisfaction of killing your final target or completing the mission, it's really, really, really satisfying. But yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed this Dishonored 2 exclusive gameplay that I have for you guys. I'm really excited for this game to come out, all right? Dishonored 1 was one of my favorite games, and I really wanna make a bunch of Dishonored videos when the game comes out. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Okay, like I said, go check out that full Dishonored 2 gameplay video that I uploaded, okay? It's, it really makes you really hyped for the game. I think the game comes out November 11th of this year, okay? So be sure to look out for that, and yeah. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video, man. Slater, guys. Love you. Bye-bye.